By now, you've probably heard about the Laurel vs. Yanny phenomenon. In case you missed it, here's the clip that started it all.
Laurel. Laurel.
Let's hear that again.
Laurel.
So, what'd you hear? Laurel or Yanny? This question is driving the internet insane. In order to settle the debate once and for all, we're gonna talk to Tyler Perrachione, a neuroscientist at Boston University studying speech and language. Okay, hey Tyler, so first question, are you a Yanny or a Laurel? I'm a Laurel.
It sounds a lot like Yanny to me.
So what's going on? So why do I hear Laurel, but you hear Yanny?
The clip is distorted, so it has a lot of high frequency information in it, more than usual. And I just might be better at hearing these high frequencies than you.
What about a scenario where one day someone hears Yanny, but the next day they hear Laurel? Why is that happening?
That's mysterious, and that plays into our expectations and what we've just heard before. I was just across the river with some friends at MIT this morning, and we were playing with the sound, and I heard Yanny, 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 Laurel. And then it wouldn't stop sounding like Laurel to me. Just like that, the same clip, we didn't change anything, it just switched. In psychology, they call this a bistable illusion. It's a technical word for you can hear it one way or you can hear it another way. And what makes you hear it one way or the other when everything else is controlled is a total mystery.
So did you think that the clip was altered or that someone had like intentionally screwed with it?
No, it sounds like one of those like recordings of a recording of a recording, you know, like maybe somebody used their phone to record it off a computer and it just was missing that low frequency information that's so important for figuring out what the speech sounds are. It was Laurel, but as soon as it got distorted, it was Yanny.
What are some of the other reasons that people might hear a difference? Like, why do you always hear Yanny, but I always hear Laurel?
It turns out that the different speech sounds we hear depend on what frequencies are in those sounds. So some sounds that we make, like ah and mm, have a lot of low frequency information in them. And sounds like e or s have a lot of high frequency information in them. And the difference between Laurel and Yanny is whether the information is low frequency, like Laurel, or high frequency, like Yanny. So a sound like ya at the beginning of Yanny has some high frequency information in it, but that distinguishes it from a sound like lol in Laurel. So if you're looking at a clip like this one, where the high frequencies have been emphasized because of the distortion, it's going to have some people hear those high frequencies and think the speech is different than what it really is. But some people have trouble hearing high frequencies, either because they're getting older, or they went to a lot of rock concerts, or they're in an environment that's noisy, or they're listening on headphones that aren't very good. And anything out there that takes the high frequencies out of the signal is going to emphasize those low frequencies and let people hear Laurel like there is in the original clip.
So could the kind of device or the headphones I'm using impact how I hear this?
I actually have two pairs of headphones here at the office, one for work that has a really nice flat frequency response and one for listening to music, which emphasizes the bass. And when I listen on the music headphones, I hear Laurel every time. And when I listen on my work headphones, I hear Yanny every time. So if you have something that picks up those low frequencies or attenuates the high frequencies, it's going to change which way you hear the sound.
What about on the phone? Like when you talk on the phone, do people sound different?
Telephones filter out only a certain amount of frequencies, only from 600 hertz to 3600 hertz. And that takes a lot of high frequency information out. So if you take this clip and you play it over the telephone to someone, they're almost certainly going to hear Laurel.
Is there a way to get people who hear Laurel to hear Yanny instead?
You can certainly take people who hear Yanny and get them to hear Laurel, because you can take the clip and emphasize the low frequencies, you can filter the high frequencies out, so it's this combination of what's in your ears, what's around your ears, and what's in your mind that determines whether you hear one or the other.
So what happens when you shift the pitch of an audio clip? What do people hear differently?
This is a really interesting thing about how speech is produced, because we can change the pitch of our voice, or we can change frequencies that our mouth is emphasizing. So for instance, I can say the word high, I can say it with a high pitch or a low pitch, high, high, and you still hear the word high, right? What we have going on in the word Yanny or Laurel in this clip is which frequencies are being emphasized by the mouth and the tongue, not the pitch of the sound. So the pitch of the sound doesn't change whether you're gonna hear Yanny or Laurel just by itself. Now it gets more complicated because men tend to have lower pitched voices and women tend to have higher pitched voices. But men also tend to have longer vocal tracts that would make it more likely that this sound was Laurel. And people who hear the sound as Laurel say, oh, I hear a man saying it. Women tend to have shorter vocal tracts, which gives them frequencies like what we hear when we hear the word Yanny. So people who hear Yanny also think it sounds maybe a little more like a woman, maybe a little more ambiguous.
So beyond Yanny versus Laurel, are there other kinds of phenomena or other kinds of things that people, you know, might like to listen to or that would give kind of similar effects?
Oh, there's all sorts of fun stuff like this. We're all used to optical illusions. They have these books full of optical illusions. But if you go to the Wikipedia page for auditory illusion, there's a whole host of things you can do here. There's shepherd's tone, which sounds like it's going up in frequency forever, even though that's impossible. There is this phenomenon of a missing fundamental, which is if you take a note and you take the fundamental frequency out of it, it still sounds like it has the same pitch, even though it's made up of different frequencies. In speech, there's this classic McGurk effect, which is where you fuse what you're seeing in speech with what you're hearing in speech. So maybe if you're watching somebody's face, you hear them say one thing, but if you close your eyes and just listen, you hear them say something different. There's a whole host of these sorts of things where our mind puts together all sorts of little bits of information to come up with our perceived reality. And as we push those around, we can get people to hear or see or experience different things.
Thank you so much, Tyler. Really, really appreciate it.
My pleasure. Good luck with all of this.
So here's the thing. We tracked where Laurel versus Yanny really came from. It turns out the clip is from vocabulary.com under the entry Laurel. So there you have it. The truth is that the clip is saying Laurel, but no matter what you hear, you're correct.